Hello again, you two. Mr. I'm Alan here. It's Wednesday, which means it's time to write our class letter, or our letter to our new class teacher. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you one that I'm going to write. We're going to write it together, and then you guys are going to use your plan from yesterday to write your letter to your new class teacher. So make sure you got your plan from yesterday handy. So if you need to get that now, just pause the video, go and get your plan, and hit play when you're ready, and then we'll start writing our letter.
Okay, so we have a learning intention to write a letter that informs my reader. So the reader of your letter is going to be your new class teacher. So we need to show who we're writing to and who the letter's from. We need to organise our letter into short paragraphs. And we're also going to write informally. So not formally with our posh language, keep it more casual with informal language. So hopefully you've got your plan with you from yesterday. Let's take a look at that plan. I'm going to use my plan to help me with my ideas as well. Okay, so I need to start by addressing who it's to. Dear Miss Giocondi. So if you're in Beach class, you're addressing your letter to Miss Giocondi. If you're in Birch class, you're addressing your letter to Miss Miller. So if you want to write along with me, you can, changing bits to make it your own. Or if you just want to watch the video and then have a go at writing it from scratch, you can do that too, whatever works best for you. So we've addressed who the letter is to. So Beach class, yours is to Miss Giocondi. Birch class, yours is to Miss Miller. So now we need to introduce ourselves, don't we? We need to write down what our name is. Let's imagine my name's Bob. So my name is Bob, and I'll be in your class next year. Okay, so we've introduced ourselves, said our name, and while we're writing, we're going to be in their class next year. I'm going to write, I do not have any brothers or sisters. Actually, do not is a bit formal. What could I change that into? What do you think? Yeah, I can use my contraction, can't I? Instead of do not, I can write don't. I can use that apostrophe. I don't have any brothers or sisters. Okay, so now on my plan next, I need to write down who I live with. So I'm just going to imagine that Bob lives with his dad. I live with my dad. Full stop. So we've written about the brothers and sisters, we've written about where we live. What's next on the plan? What we're good at. Okay, so I'm good at basketball. Because I practice every day. So I've used that conjunction there, because. And I've also broken my letter into paragraphs as well, small chunks, so you can see a line between each chunk, each paragraph. I'm good at basketball because I practice every day at home. Right, okay. Also, I also enjoy running. And listening to music. So rather than just writing about one thing that you enjoy, perhaps you can put two or three things that you enjoy to add a bit more information. Okay, my favourite film. So ask us about our favourite films next on our plan. Well, I'm going to put my favourite film is Frozen, but there's that conjunction again. My favourite film is Frozen, but I like most Disney films. There we go. All right, what's next on our plan? What I'd like to be when I'm older. So I'm going to start a new paragraph. I'm going to leave a line. I would like to be a vet when I grow up. And see if you can give a reason as to why you want to do that. I would like to be a vet when I grow up because I would, let's change that into I'd, more informal. I would like to be a vet when I grow up because I'd like to help animals. So you're given a reason about why you want to do that. Okay, my friends. So my friends are, they can write the names of our friends. To write maybe a bit about how we work with our friends as well. So you could say I work really well with, and decide which friends you work really well with so your class teacher knows. And then our favourite subjects as well. So again, like you did with what you want to be when you grow up, see if you can write down what your favourite subjects are and maybe give a reason why it's your favourite subject. So my favourite subject is English. Because I enjoy writing different types of text. My favourite subject is English because I enjoy writing different types of text. I also like PE because I enjoy sports. So I've written about two subjects and I've written why I like them as well. Sometimes. So this is a bit where we add that other information. So any information that our teacher might need to know. So maybe something we find tricky or might need some help with. So sometimes I find it tricky to keep my handwriting neat. Sometimes I find it tricky to keep my handwriting neat, so I might need some help. I like to be helpful. So if you have any jobs I might be able to help. And this is where we sign off our letter now. So a little message for our class teacher at the end. So thank you for reading my letter. I hope you have a great summer. I'm sure your class teacher will really like a nice little message at the end. I can't wait to meet you. There we go, let's just finish our letter with a nice little message to our teacher and then write who it's from at the end. So there we have it, there's our letter. So if you want to write it from scratch, you can, or if you want to play the video again, do it bit by bit, changing bits of mine to help you, you can if you want to. But I'm really looking forward to seeing what your letters look like, and I'm sure your new class teachers next year will enjoy them too.
There you have it. You have your letter ready to go to your class teacher. It would be really great if you can send that letter that you've written to our Year 2 home learning email address. And what I'll do is I'll pile them all together, and then we'll make sure that those letters that you've written go to your new class teacher, and I'm sure they're very much looking forward to reading them. I'm sure they'll have a great time getting to know you as well. So well done. That was a tough job that you had today, but you did really well. Very much looking forward to reading them. So enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll see you again soon. Take care for now, UT. Bye.